One of the criteria on which we base the search for extraterrestrial life is to find exoplanets with conditions similar to Earth. This is a rocky planet orbiting a sun-like star within the habitable zone with water and a magnetic field. The problem is that many scientists have proposed that life could emerge in other forms that we do not know and do not resemble those on Earth. In the universe, there could be many forms of life that are not based on carbon like all living beings on Earth, but rather their basic structure would be formed with other compounds. That being the case, there is a world in our solar system that could have everything necessary to house living beings different from those on Earth. We are talking, of course, about Titan, Saturn's largest moon. Recently, the James Webb Space Telescope made an astonishing discovery about this distant world that could help us discover if extraterrestrial beings could inhabit Titan. Do you want to know what this discovery is about? Come with us to find out. Titan is not only Saturn's largest moon, but it is also even bigger than the planet Mercury, with a diameter of 3,200 miles. Since the solar system began to be explored in the 1960s, Titan has been, until now, the world most similar to Earth that we have found, since phenomena occur on this moon that do not occur anywhere else except on Earth. To begin with, Titan has lakes, seas, and rivers, with the abysmal difference that while on Earth these bodies are generally full of water, on Titan, they are full of liquid methane. But this is not all. Thanks to the Cassini-Huygens space mission, scientists discovered that beneath the surface of Titan, about 50 miles deep, there is an immense ocean of water like that of Europa, Jupiter's icy moon. Another incredible phenomenon that we discovered thanks to the Cassini mission was that on Titan, there is a hydrological cycle similar to that on Earth. Thanks to this, some clouds condense and fall to the surface as rain on Titan, and then these liquids fill its seas and rivers. Of course, what rains on Titan is not water but methane, a chemical compound that here on Earth only exists in the form of a gas. But on Titan, the climatic conditions and the extreme cold of minus 290 degrees Fahrenheit cause that this element can exist in the three states, fulfilling a function analogous to the function that water fulfills here on Earth. If an astronaut could land on the surface of Titan, he would notice a couple of extraordinary things. For starters, he would realize that he could jump very high with little effort, since the acceleration due to gravity on Titan is only 1,352 meters squared, that is only 14% of Earth's gravity. This weak force of gravitational attraction would not only affect an astronaut, but it affects everything on Titan, which is why when the astronaut carefully observed the rain, he would see how it seems to fall in slow motion, since with such a weak force of gravity, raindrops fall about 6 times slower than on Earth. A day on Titan. Despite the similarities with our planet, some phenomena on Titan that do not occur on Earth could hinder life's development. One of them is its dense cloud cover. During midday on Titan, the moon's temperatures increase slightly, which cause a dense and thick layer of clouds to rise in the atmosphere that extends several kilometers. But don't think that this happens only for a couple of hours. Let's remember that Titan is a moon, not a planet. Unlike on Earth, where the day is marked by the speed of rotation, on Titan, the days are marked by both the speed of rotation and the speed of translation, that is, the time it takes to orbit the planet. Titan takes 16 days to go around Saturn, and it also has tidal coupling with Saturn, meaning that the same thing happens to it that happens to the moon. One of its faces always points to the planet on which it rotates. One of Titan's faces always points towards Saturn, so the time of its translation and rotation are equal. This means that a day on Titan lasts 16 Earth days, or 384 hours. During these 16 days, 8 days are light and 8 days are total darkness. During Titan's midday, after the first 8 days after sunrise, an orange haze rises in the atmosphere, making the sky darken between 100 and 1,000 times darker than Earth's sky. This is because the change in temperatures causes methane and ethanol to change state and form dense clouds of hydrocarbons. These clouds remain like this for most of the day until sunset. Contrary to Earth, where the brightest time is usually midday, on Titan the brightest time is sunset. This is due to Titan's tilt axis. It orbits approximately at the same angle as Saturn's rotation axis, so the time when it receives the most significant radiation is not midday, but at sunset and midday. Dark clouds form and dissipate until that moment, so Titan receives the most significant amount of radiation and sunlight during twilight. The nights on Titan are incredibly dark. It is only darker when an eclipse occurs. Earth is not the only place where eclipses occur. On Titan, they also occur. But on Earth, solar eclipses last just over a minute, while on Titan, eclipses last 6 hours. This is because what darkens the sky on Titan is not a moon, but Saturn. And Saturn is enormous. So much so that the time it takes from the first moment that one of its sides hides the sun until the sun rises on the other, 6 hours pass. Discovery of the James Webb. Recently, the James Webb Space Telescope managed to take one of the clearest images ever obtained of Titan, and scientists discovered something extremely interesting. Thanks to the fact that the James Webb Telescope can observe in the infrared, it was able to penetrate Titan's dense cloud cover and observe an astonishing phenomenon. Titan has weather seasons like Earth. You did hear that right. In the images obtained by the James Webb, astronomers were able to observe the formation of clouds in Titan's lower atmosphere at the end of summer when its surface absorbs more heat. Remember that we have four seasons on Earth that differ very well: spring, summer, autumn, and winter. On Titan, there are also four seasons. And although they have the same names as the seasons on Earth, they are very different. While on Earth, each season lasts approximately 3 months, on Titan, each season lasts approximately 7 years. This is because Titan's seasons depend on the planet's orbit, and Saturn's orbit around the Sun is approximately 29 Earth years. A year on Titan lasts 29 Earth years, so each season is divided into a quarter of a year, that is, 7 years. With this discovery, scientists know more about Titan's complex climate and can better understand what kind of life could thrive in this cold world. What type of living beings could Titan house? When scientists try to speculate what kind of life there could be on Titan, they come across different scenarios. On the one hand, meteorological phenomena are very similar to those of early Earth that occurred on Titan. Millions of years ago, our planet was not the green and blue oasis it is now. Instead, it was a cold, cloud-covered world with conditions very similar to those we observed on Titan. This means that if life could also arise on Earth under these conditions, it is possible that the same thing could also happen on Titan. The main difference is the extreme temperatures. Titan is an icy world. On Earth, living beings can take advantage of the radiation and light of the sun to charge themselves with energy and perform some functions. But Titan is a moon very far from the sun, and its atmosphere is also covered with clouds for 7 long years, further decreasing the atmosphere's temperature and surface. This means that the life forms that developed on Titan could not depend solely on solar energy to cover their energy reserves. They would have to develop another method to obtain energy. There are two ways they could achieve this. The first is geothermal energy. Although it is not proven, observations from space missions indicate that Titan could have geological activity. If so, it is possible that in the most profound areas of Titan seas, there could be underwater volcanoes. These types of volcanoes are also found on Earth, and thanks to the heat emanating from them, many life forms can form complete ecosystems around them, developing different adaptations and feeding on microorganisms. If Titan has underwater volcanoes like Earth, life could develop in these ecosystems just as it has happened on our planet. Another way life could arise on Titan is if it were completely different from what we know. On Earth, life is based on carbon and depends strongly on the energy it obtains from the sun. Plants carry out photosynthesis with sunlight. Herbivorous animals feed on these plants, and carnivores feed on herbivorous animals. Everything is linked to the sun. But on Titan, life forms could not depend on sunlight since it is very scarce. Instead, they would have to develop another type of biology. On Earth, the cell membranes of living beings are made of particular molecules known as phospholipids. These molecules are like sperm with two tails. The head of the phospholipid has two charges like a magnet, positive and negative, while the tail has a neutral charge. When they are in the water, these molecules come together like a sandwich and form a membrane where the heads of the molecules point outward, forming a wall, and the tails, having a neutral charge, seek to move away from the water, staying inside, protected by the wall of the phospholipids. This arrangement creates flexible membranes that allow life to develop within them. These molecules took advantage of our planet's elements, such as oxygen and carbon. Unfortunately, these molecules cannot form in icy environments like Titan. So if life were to develop on this moon, it would have to find another molecule to replace phospholipids. This molecule could be acryl nitrile, a liquid that only exists synthetically on Earth. It does not exist in nature since it requires hydrocarbons for production. Acryl nitrile is colorless with a pungent odor, similar to onion or garlic, and can dissolve in water and evaporate quickly at warm temperatures. Scientists believe that because temperatures on Titan are very low and hydrocarbons are abundant, acryl nitrile could form naturally, just as phospholipids form naturally on Earth. If this were to happen, life would find a substitute that fulfills precisely the same function, and this could give rise to forms of life that we have never seen or imagined. These life forms would not require sunlight and could feed on the chemicals in Titan's atmosphere. They could be transparent, and thanks to low gravity, they could easily float in the clouds. That being the case, the aliens on Titan would be similar to floating jellyfish, similar to those Carl Sagan once imagined on Jupiter. Unfortunately, no form of life has been observed on Titan. So, if extraterrestrial beings existed, they would surely be microbes, although that would still be a revolutionary discovery. Can you imagine if we were to find living beings based on Titan? Our conception of how life can form would change. The number of exoplanets where we could find life in the universe would skyrocket, since we would not limit ourselves to finding planets like Earth within the habitable zone. Still, we could also search for life on colder worlds like Titan. And if life can develop in a world like Titan, it could eventually evolve into a more advanced and intelligent species. What type of beings could evolve in these mysterious and fascinating environments? Your opinion is most important to us, so tell us. Do you think we will find any form of life on Titan? Could life emerge on cold worlds utterly different from Earth? Leave your opinion in the comments.